been very emotional. The thing that we're seeing is parents, carers, children together, which is very unique. We're coming together with a common ground, so it's kind of bittersweet really, because the things that are coming together are really great. Some parents and some children and some organisations, what we're going through and what we're all seeing is horrendous. But, you know, we've got this positivity, we're all coming together here now and we're seeing them. So, it's fantastic.
A lot of young people, their only option really is to be out of county at very expensive placements in residential.
My son was bottlenecked into a school, he's registered blind and has autism, and he was put into a school based on him being a braillist. And the only school that could provide the equipment and the support was one particular school that was in primary school, and then we had the same battle when he went up to high school. He was allowed to go to one school, but we were given the choice of school, we were allowed to take the boxes of our school choices, and we knew that we didn't have a chance. So he was forced to go to that school.
What they should be obsessed about is looking after the children in their care, giving them a good education and sending them out in the world as the best people they can be. And that's what we're trying to achieve.
There are loopholes through the Quality Artism Work Paper's written on. There are so many ways to manipulate. You can give somebody a choice of school by letting them fill out that document, but then you're not giving them a choice of school because you know what school they have to go to, provisions for that child are only in that school.
And it's not just, you know, the older young people. It's from early years. It's from the minute they come into the system, services are being put back.
There should be strict foundations that everybody works on. The rules, this is what you do, this is what you provide, this is the method that you take, these are the assessments that you take, this is the checklist that you take when you're deciding to assess somebody's need for an educational healthcare plan. Instead of people being refused to be assessed, and then after 2 years fighting through appeals and tribunals, getting in debt, finally being granted that assessment. But that's years of fighting, but you completely exhausted after that, not to mention the debt and the crisis that the child's in at that time.